5 bad reasons to get married. Marriage is not like your high school field trip where you go if and only if your friends go too. You should be able to make your own stand instead of just following the trend. You are an adult after all, so you should be able to weigh in the good and the bad before making a decision. On top of that, just because your friends got married today doesn't mean that you should get married today too. Maybe they got married today because they are ready today, but you are not yet. Just like fruits in a tree, you can't pick a fruit before it's time. So be patient and try to get ready. It is truly a noble goal to make our parents happy, and I'm not talking about a situation where your parents suggest to you a person and then you marry that person and then you like that person. No, I'm talking about a situation where you don't want to marry that person, but because you want to make your parents happy, you do it anyway. There is a difference between arranged marriage and a forced marriage. This is okay. This, no. With all due respect to our parents, we are the ones who will be living with our spouse day in and day out. If we don't want to be in that relationship to begin with, that will open doors for bad things to happen. Plus, it is a bit ironic that you think that your parents will be happy by you being unhappy. It doesn't match. So discuss with your parents, sit them down and have a good conversation with them, heart to heart, eye to eye, and find a common ground where both of you can be happy. Don't turn your life into a cheesy, typical TV drama, because the last thing you want to do is to fake a smile on your wedding day. This usually applies to men, but I have encountered some women who have the same problem. Marriage is not the place where you go to satisfy your sexual desire whenever you want to. No. If you can't control yourself, then you should stay away from marriage, because chances are you might oppress your spouse with your untamed desires. That particular intimate relationship should be enjoyable for both partners, not just you alone. So before you get married, get a grip. Yes, you will gain a loyal companion after you get married. It is one of the things that we look for in a marriage. But that loyal companion, just like you, is a human being. Your spouse cannot fulfill that loneliness all the time. There will be moments where you will separate, whether it be temporarily or permanently. So to expect your spouse to fulfill that lonely void all the time would be to expect too much. So I think you need to learn to be at peace with being by yourself before you can live peacefully with someone else. Just because you are of a certain age doesn't mean that you are ready for marriage. Readiness for marriage may or may not come with age. You want to get married when you are ready, when you are ready to fulfill the obligation, to fulfill the responsibilities, and to fulfill your spouse's rights upon you. Your reason for marrying someone can change, even if you are currently in a marriage. If you want it to change, you can change it. It's your choice. If you think that your reason for marrying that person is not strong enough, is not good enough, then you can change to something, a reason that is. That reason, that core main reason, will form the foundation upon which you will build your marriage. So logically, you will want the foundation to be good, to be strong, to be able to withstand tough times, to be able to withstand time in general, to be able to be your anchor point for when you are experiencing moments where you feel like giving up, you feel like you are burnt out. That particular reason will be your fuel, your motivation to keep on going and keep on going until the very end. So whether you are still single or you are already in a marriage, take some time, sit down, think and reflect upon that core reason why you got married or why you want to get married, and see, is that reason worth living for, worth dying for, worth fighting for, worth taking to the grave and beyond? If it is, then that is a good reason to get married. Today we would like to talk about this particular book. It's called The Other Side of the Coin. It is